So after a tireless search on the internet, I've managed to locate just one car that happens to be miles away. It's a 1963 Sunbeam Alpine.
They're becoming far more rare these days, and prices for prime examples are in the mid-20s.
If it is exactly what I'm looking for, I won't wait to get it out on the road.
And it's listed at $8,000.
Now, if there's going to be one issue with this car, it would be that age-old problem with cars of that generation, rust. Now, this car is in Boston, which is on the eastern northern side of America, and they put salt on the roads very much like we do in the UK, and that means rust will get into those dark and dirty corners where it would just fester for years to come. And if this car has got any tin worm, I'll be fighting it forever and a day. So I need to have my wits about me and make sure that this car is as rust-free as we could possibly get.
You Eric?
Yes, I am. Mike, are you?
Eric, how you doing?
Nice to meet you, buddy.
Nice to see you. You all right?
I'm good.
And who's this little man?
My son, Jed.
You all right?
Mm-hmm.
Were you off to school?
Yep.
See you, buddy. See you after school.
Have a good one. So this is the car.
This is the car.
Wow.
It's a 1963 Alpine Sunbeam. It's been sitting around for 20 years, roughly. It was
wow.
A former race car, so that's why it kind of looks like the condition it does.
Should we open the bonnet and see this engine?
Yeah, not a problem.
Unfortunately, it's not the Tiger.
No, it is not.
The V8, but it's a little four-cylinder, twin-carb setup.
Not a dot of rust anywhere. That little fuse board over there, I can see barely anything's connected to it. So do the electrics work or not?
No, not all the electric works. Because it was used as a race car, they used the bare minimums of what they needed to get it to run.
I knew that would be one of the weak areas, and that's a point to look at. Let's have a look inside. Wow, look at that. Everything's been stripped out to make it a little racing car. And that's a good thing, because it means I can see this floor.
Which is rust-free.
I mean, it's like it come out of a factory. Thank God they kept the original dashboard, which is nice. With the original dials, that's very period. So what about this roof?
Well, this is a removable hardtop.
I've looked at quite a few of these online. Most of them are convertible. They don't have the hardtop for sale. So this becomes a rare item.
Another telltale sign of the car's racing past is the old-school fuel cell.
Remarkable. And the chrome is fantastic as well. The only thing I need to make sure is that it actually does do what it does on the tin. Gets down the road. It starts, stops, and it goes. So if you don't mind, I'd like to take it for a test drive.
Go right ahead.
Well, here I am in a Sunbeam Alpine. And when I was referring to Britain's favourite spy, Mr. James Bond, and that would be Sean Connery in Dr. No, driving one of these around, I gather he felt a little bit better than I do right now in this one, because this is like James Poverty, not James Bond. I feel like 003.5. And this is kind of terrifying, because there's a lot of snow on the road, and I'm in a car that's rear-wheel drive with brakes that still think they're in 1963. So what I'll do is make sure that this car has got a thorough wash after, both underneath and on the outside, to get rid of all that salt, because it will rot the car. I've done a few miles now. That twin-carb setup feels a little bit vague, it feels a little bit tired. The suspension feels really tight, but it also feels really hard. So that could be tired as well. This car needs a whole lot of work. But this is what it is. This is a Sunbeam Alpine. It is completely rust-free. This is a rare car, and it's got a detachable hardtop. That makes it even rarer. It separates itself from the other cars out there. The truth is, Eric wants $8,000 for this car, and I think it's worth that. But I need to make sure I give me and Ed a good head start. But I reckon we're going to meet somewhere in the middle around 7, and if I can make that happen, this car will be an absolute steal.
Mike, what do you think?
Exciting. That's what 1963 feels like, driving that car. I just think you want too much money for it. What was your number?
$8,000.
See, I think it's worth $6,000. You know, the money I'm going to spend on this car, just in parts alone, is going to be astronomical.
I have some parts here that you can use to put this car back together that's going to save you some money.
Okay, well, I'm interested. What are they?
Let's take a peek. Right here, I have center console, exhaust, lenses, rear screen, everything's here.
It does make a difference, but the car is still too expensive.
I've got three other people waiting to look at the car.
Oh, okay. $6,500. $6,500.
$6,500's not gonna do it.
Come on, have a deal with me.
$7,000.
Okay, $7,000, hold out your hand. And I just bought myself a Sunbeam Alpine. I think for $7,000 on all of those parts, I've got a proper little bargain. I can see a profit on the horizon. Fantastic. My name is Brewer, Mike Brewer.
I thought you were familiar.
How are you, mate? Look at this. All the way from Boston with love, the little Sunbeam Alpine.
So it's going to be riddled with rust.
You would think so, wouldn't you? Northeast, salt on the roads, but actually, this is quite a rare find. When they was filming Dr. No in Jamaica, they needed to find a little sports car for Sean Connery to drive around in. Mm-hmm. And the only one on the island happened to be a little Sunbeam Alpine. So they borrowed that, and that's why this car became famous. So under the bonnet, for your eyes only, that was quite good.
Oh, look at that, Mr. Brabham. So this could be a full-on Brabham race engine. But, I mean, do we have any documentation or proof that this is what it should be?
No, but he was the guy who came up with the idea to put a V8 engine in the little Sunbeam Alpine. That went on to become the Tiger. Mm-hmm. And you know what happened to them?
Well, recently, the prices have gone through the roof.
They've gone skyrocketing in their prices. I mean, you're talking six-figure sums, and we could never afford one of them. But we've got an upgrade of the car that James Bond would have driven back in the film Dr. No. So we're sort of 007 and a bit, if you like.
Okay. The interior, you've got all the dials on the dashboard, which needs a bit of work. I mean, what kind of things do you want to do with this? Do you want to go for kind of luxury, or do you want to keep it racy?
Well, I think we need to retain that racy heritage that this car might have. That's very important. But we need to make it a bit more luxurious. We should go for a nice luxurious interior like the GT did have, because this is a GT car.
Okay. I mean, well, it has got that lovely GT hardtop, but it doesn't really fit. It'd be nice if it did. We've got a bit of a gap there on the A-pillar. It doesn't fit down here in the back.
Oh, stop moaning. You just need your golden fingers to be working on it. I did it again.